I'm Janelle, this is toDIYfor, and it was a couple of weeks ago I went out on my Instagram page and asked for some suggestions for some upcoming DIYs. So if you're not already following me there, it's at Janelle Steeper. I often go there for suggestions, and I often give sneak peeks of my DIYs as well. So definitely go check that channel out. You can follow me at Janelle Steeper. And one of the suggestions I got were for some accessories that are kind of spring and summer related. And I've made plenty of bags in the past, and it's because I like to kind of swap out my bags for the season. And when I was at the thrift store, I found the perfect pillowcase to transform into a purse. So I'm going to show you how I did that with all of the items I used coming from the thrift store. Okay, so everything here is from the thrift store, and these I thought were just beautiful pillow cases that have been embroidered. I thought they'd make a really pretty purse. This one in particular, because it has an opening here with the buttons, so I'm just going to keep using that as my closure for my purse. I've got a belt here, and then I also picked up some scrap fabric from the thrift store that I'm going to use to create an insert for this purse, just to double up on the fabric. It's a little thin. So I'm just laying this out here. It's okay if you don't really need to give a seam allotment, just because you almost want this to be a little bit smaller than the purse itself. So I've cut out this length that is twice as long as my purse, folded in half. I'm going to stitch along those two long open sides with a single straight stitch. Flip your bag right side out. Then I'm going to stitch this along the back. So I've stitched it along the back and halfway around the front, but I need to tuck my bag now into my purse, and then I'm going to hand stitch the rest of this little opening here. I couldn't figure out a way to do this with my sewing machine to keep it clean and to not have stitches show through the front, because I don't want it to go through the embroidery, so that's why I hand stitched that. Next, I'm just pulling apart this belt, get rid of that belt buckle, and then on the opposite end of the belt, we need something to hoop it through some fabric. So I've got this binder clip that I'm weaving in and out of this belt, and that is why I picked this belt. I didn't want one that was a straight leather belt, because it's impossible to sew leather unless you have a really good sewing machine. So what I'm doing is using these metal hoops to put some fabric through to then sew it to my bag. So I've got these fabric strips here that I've sewn in to just make it a little cleaner and a little sturdier with the doubling up on that fabric. I've looped them around, and then I'm doing a zigzag stitch here. Again, I thought that would be stronger, and I sewed it to the back of the bag just so you couldn't see any of the stitching in that embroidery on the front. So like I've said, I've actually made quite a few different bags and purses on this channel. I'll leave some of them linked up above for you, also down below if you're interested in checking them out. I know a couple of them have been beach bag themed, and most of the items came from the dollar store. So check those out if you're interested, and let me know what you thought of this bag. I'm so happy I stumbled upon that beautiful pillowcase, and I'm happy I have another one. I might actually make a whole another purse. I'm not sure yet, but I really think it made this look way more expensive than it actually was. Let me know what you thought of the DIY in the comments down below. Give the video a like, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll be back next Wednesday with a new video. Cheers.